episode 7, March 2nd. Happy Monday to all Central Valley folks. Good morning, and let's begin.
I've been waiting all week, take me anywhere you wanna. Tell me where to go, cause I'm new to California. I can bring the packs and she don't know how to roll up. Talk about your culture, I'm trying to get to know you.
The more they spent, the more businesses grew, the more wages rose.
Long-term investors can potentially benefit.
I look to the business to determine whether I made a good investment.
So you're young, you're in your 20s, and there's one to two things that you could possibly be doing. You're either working full-time job, not going to school, or you could be going to school, or you could be going to school and working a job, or you could be working, oh no, I already said that. Yeah, one of those. And you find yourself, you know, making some money, and because you don't have a family, you haven't, you know, bought a home yet, it's too early for us, you find yourself with a little extra income. And so now you found content on social media where you can invest that extra money that you have in your hands to then create more profits further along the lines, further along time. And so, but here's the question, because I think investing young is super hard. Maybe I'm just, no, I know there's more people. So we're young, we're in our 20s, and yeah, we want to invest, but at the same time, we also want to live a little. We then turn 21. You know, we start drinking, we start partying, clubbing, doing friend trips. We just want to have fun right now. You know, we're young. And it's almost like this energy built into us. And so that's when investing becomes hard, because doing all those things revolve around spending money. And so if you find yourself working that job, you find yourself with extra income and you're like, whoa, let's go party, let's go clubbing, let's take a trip here, which is completely fine. I kind of been realizing that, like these past weeks, I've been just thinking like, man, I mean, it's good, but then it's, if you do too much, it's bad. I'm trying to find a way in which we can do both. We can invest, prepare ourselves for, any collateral damage in our financials further along our journey, while at the same time having fun. So what I tend to do is, yes, I spent on, you know, going out to eat, drinking, but at the same time I'm focused and I try to save up at least a portion, and at least a portion is better than absolutely nothing, right? So let's say if we made $2,000 in one month, we could then invest $300 of that $2,000. And for most stock investors, they might say, no, don't go out to eat, don't take this trip, don't drink, stop drinking completely. I don't know, man. I just feel like they kind of, I mean, they have a right. If you're really trying to just go all out and be the best, make billions in the stock market, and you're that person dedicated to do that, then you are going to have to completely block off drinking, everything that involves, you know, spending. But I also don't want to turn into that person who, man, I could have like really ripped shoes, and just because I'm trying to make $1 billion, I'm not going to buy myself some shoes, you know? Or maybe I'm starving, and just because I want to make $1 billion, I'm going to starve myself to death and I'll buy myself some damn food. I don't know. That's just not me. I'm willing to find a way to kind of find a balance to have fun, live, you know, do all these young, enthusiastic adventures. Because it's when we can, you know. I think later on we're not going to be able to freaking jump on a trampoline. We're going to have back pain. It's just right now is the time. And then who knows? Maybe that phase runs off. You're like, eh, okay, I had my fun. Now I really want to put maybe a little bit more percent into investing. And now that you've gone through the phase of feeling young, then you can add more percent into the investment. Just think about that. So young people, I'll leave you guys at that. I know we want to party and have fun. It is kind of like the animal in us, I would say. I don't know. For the majority of us, I would assume. And I kind of just don't want you guys to fall in the trap of feeling that you can do anything, because in reality, you can't do anything. You'll sooner or later find it that you're financially stuck, and you're gonna continue that cycle of, you know, just continuing being in debt. And then I don't want you guys to get depressed. Yeah, I just want to kind of help you guys to understand that if you start, you know, sooner than later, you're gonna be better off. I don't want you to be like in your 30s and be like, ah, there's no hope, I'm already here, you know, F it, I'm just gonna do me. You know, no, like, come on, there's hope. Let's start early. Just maybe even just thinking about these things is good enough. I think you're more ahead of the game if you start thinking about these things versus later on not knowing anything and feeling hopelessness of your finances, because it's a tough world out there. So I'll leave you guys at that. And with that being said, it is your small investor, Surf. We continue learning, grinding, hustling, while at the same time doing a little drinking, partying. You know, let's have fun, but let's also use our mind and prepare for the future. Until next time, guys. Peace. Tell me where to cash at. Yeah, 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 yeah. Tell me where to take it easy. Yeah. Tell me where to cash at. I've been